With the Parliament transacting no business in the first 2 days, today will be a very big day in Parliament. In fact, the government has given in to the opposition's demand for a debate on price rise, that too under a rule that entails voting, and the Lok Sabha will see a discussion on inflation under Rule 184. This is likely to pitch the government against the force of the opposition and could also open up the numbers game. The BJP triumphant, they've won the first round of confrontations. They may push for a vote on the price rise issue.
We have debated it 2-3 times, 4 times in the Parliament. But if effective action is not coming about under an economist prime minister, an eminent economist prime minister, then as the opposition, we are entitled to enforce accountability through the instrument of voting, apart from debate. That's what we are demanding. If they have agreed, good luck to them.
They wanted discussion under a certain class. We don't want to take any confrontation with opposition. Better that Parliament is run in cordial atmosphere. So we discussed the whole issue, the resolution, what kind of resolution should be, you know, acceptable to all the concerned. And after that we decided to go ahead. So under section 184 we accepted the debate on price, right? Nobody has given in and nobody has scored. The Parliament works in mutual cooperation. It should be seen in that context.
We have been saying, and there is a right with open mouth, that the policy of the government and economic policy is one of the main reason for price rise. The food stuff price has gone twice and thrice. You have not controlled. You every time the petrol rise, gas rise, everything is only for the food stuff inflation.
In the monsoon session of the last year, same kind of discussion took place on price rise, and both the houses passed unanimous resolution. After that, during 1 year, nothing has been done. Rather, the government allowed all prices to go up, including the prices of diesel, petrol, LPG, etc. So we think it is necessary that government should be held responsible for inaction, for remaining insensitive to the question of price rise and sufferings of Aam Aadmi.
So even as Parliament was stalled on Tuesday over inflation and land acquisition issues, the government and the opposition have agreed to have a debate on inflation today. Now this seems to have paved the way for Parliament to function normally, unless there are any further adjournments. Let's also tell you that on Tuesday, BJP members, led by Senior Leader Venkaiah Naidu, had called for the suspension of the questioner in Rajya Sabha to discuss price rise. As far as the Lok Sabha is concerned, we saw MPs storm the well of the House and also demand answers from the government as far as Kalmari's appointment is concerned. Let's go across to Nandita Suneja, joining us live from the capital. Nandita, it promises to be another big day in Parliament with a debate that entails voting lined up.
Yes, Niranjan, in fact, the strategy from the government's end seems to be that they don't want similar scenes repeating themselves like we've seen on day one and day two, day one in Rajya Sabha and then yesterday in both houses of Parliament. That's why a quick decision taken yesterday at the Business Advisory Committee's meeting of the government,
which would entail voting at the end of that debate, something that the opposition, both the left and the BJP, have been asking for. So the attempt, really, the strategy of the government seems to be to not waste much time and to get business started immediately. Today, 11 o'clock, question hour will take place as regular, and then at 12 noon, the discussion on price rise, to which Finance Minister Pranab Mukherjee would reply. It is going to be a long debate, which will go on into the evening, which would finally end with a division of votes, something that the opposition had been asked for and the government seems to have given in.
Now, if it all comes down to the numbers game, give us a sense of who stands where.
Well, for the time being, Niranjan, the government seems to be quite comfortable as far as arithmetic is concerned. They've done their math with the figures, and it's a comfortable position for the government. Of course, the left and the BJP command a huge number in the Rajya Sabha, but with the Samajwadi Party and smaller parts, which the government can always
Fall back on in times like this. Even in the last session, we have seen the government counting on the SP and even BSP on certain bills. So the government seems to be in a comfortable spot for the time being, and that's why perhaps the eagerness to agree to a division of votes after this debate. Niranjan.
All right, Nanita, stay with us. We also have Tarun Vijay of the BJP joining us this morning. Thank you, Mr. Vijay, for joining us. First of all, it promises to be a big day for you in the parliament. Why is your party so keen on a debate that entails voting in parliament?
I think it's a people's demand and it's a big day for the people of India. The government has completely failed to check price rise and to control the rising index of inflation. The growing corruption and the loot of India has also directly contributed to the price rise and the suffering of the masses. In the last one quarter only, the prices have risen more than 80% to 200%, and petroleum prices have been increased three times. This is a crime against the people of India, and hence it was found necessary that it should be put on vote so that the people know that who are with whom. Hence, we have decided to grill the government, and with full arsenal, we will be entering parliament this morning.
But Mr. Vijay, you do know that if it all comes down to the number game, your party does not have the numbers stacked up for you.
It's not a matter that how many numbers they have and how many numbers we have. We just want to show that a vast majority, which cannot be ignored, and they represent the people's will. The democracy is not just a number game, it's also a moral authority. So, today India stands with the opposition.
You know, Mr. Vijay, as far as the numbers go, are you confident of support from, let's say, the left parties?
Of course, the left parties have also given the same notices, and on this issue, we hope that the entire opposition will speak in one voice.
You know, what about the CAG report on the Commonwealth Games scam and Kalmadi's appointment yesterday? The sports minister did make a statement. He blamed the NDA government for that. Will you again corner the government on his appointment?
At the surface of it looks like a hilarious argument. It's no argument at all. I mean, the government is so defensive, it has lost all balance and is groping for words. It has no defense shield left to it, and it is every day. It is coming out in a very shabby and indefensible manner. It's trying to defend itself.
You know, even fingers have been pointed at your government, Mr. Vijay. As far as 2003 goes, there have been findings that also point fingers at the NDA government as far as Kalmadi's appointment was concerned. So your response to what the government will say in Parliament today?
See, look at the incidents. Sunil Dutt was being appointed first as the chairperson of the CWG Games Organizing Committee. The question is, why was Sunil Dutt's name deleted? And nobody is answering that thing. Kalmadi's appointment by NDA is simply frivolous, has no basis, and it can be dismissed at its first, at its surface value.
Right, Mr. Tarun Vijay of the BJP joining us this morning, also giving us a sense of what we can expect in Parliament today. A debate that entails voting. By the end of the day, we should be able to get a better idea of what really happens as far as the numbers game goes. Let's also tell you that today the Parliament will see a debate on inflation and price rise in the Lok Sabha. And we're also expecting some fireworks after yesterday the proceedings were disrupted.